Welcome to a week in my life of a line friend's intern, and this is how I start my day. I got my head out the sunroof. I'm blasting my favorite tunes. I only got one thing on my mind. Just kidding. Whoever wakes up like that is borderline psycho.
Am I right?
No? Just me? Well, this is how I actually start my day. Good morning, it's Monday. My alarm goes off at 8:30, but I stay in bed for 10 to 15 minutes on my phone. I get my daily dose of social media first thing in the morning to wake up my dead brain cells. After I make my bed, I go make myself some tea. I've been drinking tea every day in the morning since I started my internship. Now it's basically an addiction. Anyways, after that, I turn on some soft music and read the Bible. It just feels right to start the morning with some spiritual rejuvenation, you know? After that, I catch up on more social media. Around 9:45, I get washed up and get ready to go to work. Technically, I don't go to work. Since I work from home due to COVID lockdown, I just change into a more socially acceptable version of PJs, take a few steps to my desk, turn on the laptop, and then bam, I'm a working ass woman now. Work starts from 10 a.m., but I get everything set up by 9:55, like log into Line, connect the VPN, turn on some music. I try to clock in a few minutes before 10 because I'm a goody two shoes who cares about brownie points. And now my workday begins. For those who have been wondering, I'm a digital marketing intern at Line Friends. There are many things that I do, but I can't really explain because even I have trouble understanding what I'm doing sometimes, you know what I mean? But my main job is to take care of all the Line Friends social media accounts. I create the social media captions and upload the posts whenever there are new products that are coming out. Sounds easy, right? Well, believe it or not, it's harder than it sounds. Anyways, 12:30 to 1:30 is lunch break. I head over to the kitchen to make myself some lunch and watch Netflix while I eat. This K-drama is so cringy. But that's why I watch it. After lunch break, it's work, work, work till 7 p.m. Sitting for a long time really hurts my back, so sometimes I work standing. This is the sad reality of working from home, guys. Later, I took a little snack break and did some happy stretching because I only had less than an hour to go till I get off work. But yeah, once there's only like 10 minutes left, as you can tell, I slowly lose it. Before I clock off, I write down all the tasks I've done today and send it to the Line group chat. Turn off the laptop, and then just like that, work's done. I head straight to working out to release all the stress and some butt fat I accumulated from sitting all day. I've been going to a kickboxing gym for more than like 8 months now. I realized I really enjoy punching and kicking things, so I never quit. I get home around 8:30 once I'm done working out, but no time to rest because at 8:45 my tutoring class starts. I teach English through Zoom for 1 hour and 15 minutes. I end class by 10, and this is finally the time I'm done with everything I needed to do for the day. So I go on my bed, scroll through Instagram or TikTok, then go bother my roommate. After the roommate therapy session, I get washed up and finally head to bed around 11:30. But before I go to sleep, of course, I gotta watch an episode of the current Netflix show I'm into. Then I set my alarm to repeat the day all over again. And it's already rise and shine time. Hello, Tuesday. I go through some type of exorcism in the morning, then finally get up. As usual, I make my tea and get ready to do some reading and writing. Here's a little fun fact you didn't ask for. Apparently, I have blood circulation problems, and this type of slipper with rocks on them helps with blood flow. So in the morning, during my social media catch-up session, I wear these and walk around in my room because health is important, kids. Then I wash up, do some skincare, and decide on which PJs I should go for today. I ended up changing my outfit twice. I take my PJ picking session seriously, even though the only person who sees me is me, okay? Anyways, after working from 10 to 12:30, it's time for lunch. Today, I went out to buy lunch from one of my favorite restaurants, Alchon. I literally eat this at least 2 times a week and get the same dish every single time. Jajang rice with eggs and 10 fried dumplings. With food, I'm the type of person who will eat the same thing every single day if I get into it, and currently, that is Alchon and Subway. After my 1 hour lunch break, it's time to work, work, work till 7 p.m. Unfortunately, today I got off work at 7:35. There's just something about working in a Korean environment where getting off work at exactly 7 just feels socially wrong. No working out today though. I went straight to eat dinner with my roommate. Then I quickly washed up and got ready for this weekly meeting call that happens every Tuesday at 9 to 10 p.m. We have this call to discuss important matters, and guess what? I'm the leader of the group. After the call ended, I hung out with my roommate some more. We were just laughing and giggling about stupid things as usual. Then around 11:30, I jumped into bed, did some catching up with Netflix, then finally fell asleep. Can't believe it's only Tuesday. It's Wednesday. Wow, I'm really rocking the bed hair today, aren't I? But exciting news, I'm physically going to work today. So I got ready into something more appropriate than PJs, did my usual morning rituals, then headed to work around 9 a.m. Although most of the people in the company work from home, I get called to come into the office at least once a week. I like that, because although I feel extra tired from getting up earlier and taking public transport and walking, but once I get to the office, I actually feel like an intern doing something with her life. It just feels cool that I have my own office card with my face and name on it and have access to areas non-line workers can't go into. Here's a little desk tour, nothing special. But I do really like how I have two screens to work with. From 10 to 12:30, I work and then finally go out for lunch with a few of my coworkers. The cherry blossoms are so pretty these days. After some fresh air, it's work till 7 p.m. I decided to bike home today. When I noticed bike roads near the office, I did some research and realized that I can easily and safely go home on a bike. By bus, it takes 40 minutes to get home and 15 minutes on a bike. Not much of a difference, so why not, right? I get some fresh air, exercise, and get a break from staring at a computer screen all day. Not gonna lie though, I did feel like giving up halfway through, but nonetheless, I made it home safely. And now it's time for tutoring. Finally, at 10 p.m., I get my free time. My roommate and I did some catching up, not sure why we're laughing so much there. Then I got washed up and had a skincare session. I may be barely surviving life, but at least I should do it with good skin, am I right? Honestly, Thursdays are the hardest. Monday to Wednesday tends to go by pretty fast, but Thursdays? Not a fan. After going on my phone, I forced myself out of bed, drank my tea, did the usual reading stuff, and then logged into work. I also turned on some calm music to mentally escape my stressful reality. Work setup is done. Today, I had to post something on social media on all BT21 accounts because their new product was coming out soon. For some reason, I get super nervous when doing this. I guess I'm scared that I'm going to post the wrong thing on the wrong account. After I post, I do some monitoring by writing down people's comments and reactions, which is pretty fun because I feel like a professional stalker. It's lunch break. Today, I headed out to get myself some Subway. I always get tuna sandwich with extra egg mayo and a cookie. Sometimes add extra avocado if I'm feeling a little fancy. Lunch break goes by so fast, but afterwards, you know what time it is. It's work till 7 p.m. Are you guys tired of seeing the same room, same wall, same desk, same setup, same person, always wearing PJs yet? Anyways, today I ended work at 7:40. My eyes and head were aching so much. But anyways, guess what I had for dinner? I had Subway again. And that's one cool thing about being an adult. If you want it, you can get it. As long as you have the money. Thursday is finally the day I don't have any other responsibilities such as tutoring or meetings after work, so I'm a free woman. I did another skincare session, read a book, and later did some catching up with my roommate. After I got tired of her, I kicked her out, went on my phone, and eventually fell asleep. It's finally Friday. Judging by all those morning yawns, your girl is real tired. Friday mornings are extra tiring because the end of the day seems so far away. But regardless, I woke up, made my bed, made some tea, and did my usual morning rituals. Then I changed into, yes, another pair of hoodies, and turned on Ratatouille soundtrack to lift up the morning spirit. Today I had another social media posting to do. Here's a more closer look to my main job as a digital marketer at Line Friends. I write the Korean and English captions of the posts, then on the day, I upload the posts, then check if all the links are working and the captions are correct, and do some social monitoring afterwards. If you go check out the Line Friends accounts, I'm the man behind all those pictures on the feed. Sometimes I see mutual friends give a like and I think to myself, they probably have no idea I'm the one who created the captions they just read and uploaded that post. Then afterwards, what time is it? Work till 7 p.m. time. Can you imagine sitting and staring at a computer screen for 8 hours straight, 5 days a week? I never could, but look at me now. This is my current reality. The excitement that builds up 1 hour before you end work on a Friday night is nothing compared to what I experienced as a student. Fridays and the weekends are what keeps me from going insane at work. And also kickboxing. After kickboxing, I was so ready to do something fun and crazy this Friday night. But I got a migraine, so I ended up in bed. You work so hard to have fun, but end up doing nothing because you're too tired. This pretty much sums up my current state in life. But to be continued.